Good afternoon. This is EBC News. I'm your host, Mick O'Byron. And we'll be looking at many, many, many things today. Live, of course. But the thing I'm most looking forward to is Geriatrics Jerry hat tricks. Looks very exciting. But I think there is a storm brewing. It's getting quite chilly in the studio. Oh, freezing.
Actually, you're wrong. It's very sunny and nice out here, not cold. Here it is on the map. I wish I wasn't here though. I wish I was somewhere else, like a nicer place, like Dallas. I lived half my life in Dallas. Trained 5 years to be an engineer. Didn't go out. Wasted half my life. I lost a lot in Dallas. I lost a lot in Dallas. Here's a nice picture of a dog I saw. And a video. Look at it go. Is it again?
Man found with seagull in inappropriate place in Bournemouth Beach. HP laptops plummet sales by 26% because of Dell. We don't like Dell. Queen of England, sadly, gets resurrected from the dead. Now, let's go see some interviewers with our hosts, Ron and Tahiri. They're going to be collecting some valuable information for our EBC Corporation. Here they are now.
Hi, I'm Tahiri Troublemaker Jr. III.
And I'm Ron Pickering.
And we're going to be interviewing people on the streets and see what their opinion is.
We love opinions.
Yes, we do.
EBC News.
Wow! We're here today with Diana. I know her personally. Me and her got married back in 1622. It was like amazing. I'm gonna say, what I have to say today is absolutely astounding. I'm gonna ask her a few questions now. So Diana, what would you say is your favourite shop in Bracknell? She's not much of a speaker, is she? Next question. Can I have your phone?
So nothing.
I like the silence there. Final question, is that a real pygmy goat? Well, that's Diana for you guys. Alright, we're gonna go on to the next person now.
But sadly, that person would never come. I never saw another person after that. I was going mad! I was going crazy! I didn't know what to do with my life!
It was really starting to get to my head too. I like it when things go my way and my way only, and it wasn't! It wasn't!
I was on a phone call with someone, she said I could interview her! But I don't know if she wants to, so I'm gonna interview her now, like, I don't know what to do in it!
Ask you some questions, and like, record you this.
No.
Alright.
I'm sick of this! This is out of hand! I can't do anymore. Someone save me! My God!
What a bloody surprise, she bloody said no!
Can I borrow your phone?
Absolutely got smacked! I was fuming! No one wanted to interview me!
I can't go home now. My father would be disappointed with me. I was to be a news reporter when I was 12 years old. He's my biggest inspiration. I can't do it now. But there it was.
PEOPLE!
I'm here to Troublemaker Junior III, and I'm with
Niccolo.
All right, Anton here. He's a great man. I've heard loads of stories about him. Right, so the first question is, have you watched The Godfather?
Yeah, I really thoroughly enjoyed it. I liked the part when he puts his hat on.
Oh yeah, I remember that part like it was like yesterday. Right, what do you think the minimum wage should be?
I mean, it's minimum for like £2.
And the third and final question, are you homeless?
I've got five. I don't know.
Five what?
Stones? I'm homeless?
You're crazy, you are. Come out.
Do you want to be famous?
Not really, no.
What's the worst thing you ever said to someone?
The worst thing I've ever said to someone? Probably like that's it.
Can you say it again to the camera, please? Can I borrow £10,000?
£10,000? Yeah. Alright. No. He's shocked.
How's anyone going to do that? Like, no one's going to be able to get £40,000 in a week. Are you joking? I can't do.
Give them in the cult?
Yeah, actually, I have. Basically, I run my own cult. It's called Minimend. Mm. We worship me. Right. I'm the cult leader. And they all love me.
Okay. What's the worst thing you've done in the last 24 hours?
Last 24 hours? Last night, when I was going home from work, I actually blew a tyre and my car skidded
right
into a monastery.
Is that true?
And I killed 3 nuns.
Is that true?
But I'm out on bail at the moment.
He's out on bail. What's the worst thing you've ever eaten?
Ever eaten?
Yeah.
That's a hard one, you know. I've eaten quite a lot of bad things. Campfire stew is one of the worst, but I think what slightly tops campfire stew is shit.
Mm. Got one more bonus question for him.
Bonus.
Do you please lend me £400,000?
£400,000?
I'm having a tough time right now. You just don't understand. This is serious. I need this.
I could give you 1p transfer.
1p.
On ePay. Is that good?
Not gonna bother with. And I'm with Uber. Right. We're gonna ask you a few questions. Right, question number one, have you ever been arrested?
No.
Why not?
Because I haven't.
Perfect answer. I can say that better myself. Right, question two. Have you ever stolen anything?
Yeah.
Yeah, what was it?
A chocolate bar from the co-op.
Really? Getting that, guys. Get the police on it right now. I'm not having that. And the third question. What's the three numbers on the back of your card?
What?
The three numbers on the back of your card, your credit card.
I don't know.
You don't know? Why about you have a look right now?
I haven't got my card on me.
Oh, typical. That's what they all say. We'll get them next time, folks.
Hello? Yeah, it's me, Taheli, Junior the Third. Or Troublemaker as well, you know. In brackets. Oh, I don't know. Anyway, yeah, I'm just going to let you know. I've got more interviews than you. Good joke, isn't it? Well, I just want to tell you I'm a god. I'm literally god. Anyway, I just want to know that I love myself.
Ron?
Who do you think you are?
Stay back. Just because I got more interviews doesn't mean you have to get... Oh,
I need this money. This is for my safety. This is for my safety.
To hear him. Oh my god. He was my favourite interviewer. I can't believe he got attacked by Ron. Sly devil. When he gets back to the studio, he's gonna get one. Oh, he's gonna get one, he is.
Let's watch that again, though.
This is for my safety! This is for my safety!
Alright, that's enough for now. Let's have a quick act.
Ever since I've been taking these pills, my happiness, my joy just knows no bounds. Every day is the best day of my life. I wake up, I'm so grateful to be alive. It's just nothing else like it, you know? I mean, so what? Yeah, there's a few side effects, you know? Tuberculosis, multiple sclerosis, salmonella, but I couldn't be happier. I really recommend these pills. They're exquisite.
Now, for some sad news. Our producer, Howard Bingle, dead. Sad, sad news, everyone. He's dead. D-E-D. Dead. He was shot by a stray bullet. But thankfully, his wife, Suzanne Bingle, will be giving us a call later on to tell us how much of a wonderful man Howard Bingle was, and what life was like with our producer. Thank you. What's next? Well, I've got some funny clips. Now, watch this. Now we will have a moment of silence for our producer, Alan Bingle. Now we're going to be having a call from Suzanne Bingle, the wife of Alan Bingle, our producer. Hello, is this Suzanne Bingle?
Yeah, is this Susan Bingle on the phone?
Ah, yes. Nice to catch you on this lovely Tuesday.
Well, you caught me in a bit of a bad time, really.
You're busy?
Yes, I am a bit. I'm just out doing my weekend shopping.
Shop? Where are you at?
Tesco's.
Tesco's?
Yes, Tesco's. What's wrong with that?
On a Tuesday? And it's a weekend shop?
Well, I don't really know.
I think you're crazy, you are. You're a crazy woman. No wonder how a Bingle died.
What has that got to do with anything at all?
What? Well, she hung up on me. Didn't really explain why. She was just gobbing off to me. Absolutely disgraceful. Does she know who I am? I'm the richest man alive. Oh, God! If you didn't know. But that was Suzanne Bingle for you guys. Now, we've got a quick advert break from one of our interns. We've just filmed it now. Hopefully, this will buy us a few more minutes on the air for our sad passing of Howard Bingle. He has no money left. So, hopefully, this advert will help us. I haven't watched it yet. I hope it's good. Fingers crossed.
Yeah, is this on?
Yeah, I'll try that. Try the new Nestle Kit Kat. Sustainably sourced cocoa. Have a break, have a Kit Kat.
Oh, that's good.
There it is. We just have to take just in case. Try the new Kit Kat. It's sustainably sourced cocoa. Sustainably sourced cocoa.
You've got freedom here.
Okay. Hashtag my break.
Yeah, you could talk about that.
I'm gonna use everything with it.
Yeah.
Alright.
Yeah, we'll do a couple more takes, okay?
Have a break, have a Kit Kat.
You go.
I'm telling you.
Alright.
Try the new Nestle Kit Kat. Sustainably sourced cocoa. Hashtag my break. Have a break, have a Kit Kat.
That's good.
Alright.
Right, is that enough, do you think?
Yeah.
Wow, that was phenomenal. I love that advert with all my heart. Thank you, Jamal.
This is the end of EBC. I'm glad to have joined all of you in this prized network corporation. Howard Bingle's dead. No more funding. No more supporters. We don't have any Patreons. Subscribe to our Patreon. Please, just maybe we could start up again a new channel, a new rebrand. Please, anything would be grateful. I love you all. I'm glad to be of your presenter on this network, on this channel, EBC News. It's been a pleasure. Thank you. But now, it's time to sing our favourite song. Well, it's our last song, so it may not be our favourite for some of your viewers at home, like Lewis. Now it's time to say goodbye. Good night, sleep tight. It's a fucking chip. Who let that in?